Hello, welcome to Morley TV. Today we're going to talk about effects. Effects are the cornerstone of a lot of VJ work, but it might be a bit confusing when you're starting off to know where to put those effects. Within Resolume, there's a few different places where you can put the same effect. I'm going to go through all these places and analyze what those places are best suited for so that you can make the correct choice when you start putting your effects. Here I've got this composition, which has got a single clip from my pack beta gun, which is available on Gumroad, link in the description. The most obvious place to put effects when you start off is on the clip itself. I've got a preset of iterate here, white spin 3D, and I'm just going to drag it across and put it on the clip. And as you can see, instantly it affects that content. I can switch it on and off from here, just pressing the bypass. So that's what the effect is doing. Now, what's this good for? Effects directly on clips that have content in them are good when you're trying to adjust or change that single element. This is really good for creating a generative content within Resolume where you put a source and then you stack a bunch of effects on top of it, and those effects will only be affecting that particular clip. The next place you can place effects is on the layer itself. I've added two more clips here, so I've got that and that added to that layer. And if we go to the layer and then put our effect on the layer, you'll see that now the effect will be placed on top of all the content that is across that layer. So I can click through my clips and that effect will be added automatically to that content. This is good for creating adjustments on a particular layer of content. For example, let's say you've got a layer that's only got text or captions on it and you want to style all those captions in a very similar way and have control over the effect from a single place. That's the place to put it. That means that you can just go to the effect on the layer, tweak it any way you want, and it'll be applied throughout without having to go into individual clips and change the effect every time. Another place where you can put your effects is on groups. I've split those clips I had here and I've put them on three different layers and then I've grouped them together into this group one. So you can see over here, this is the group palette over here. So if I get my Y spin 3D preset and put it on the group, that is now affecting the three clips which I played at the same time from one place. This is very similar as what we've just done, but the key here will be that you have a single place where you can adjust that effect, and that will affect all the clips that are played at the same time within that group. Another place where you can place effects is in the composition tab, which can also be known as the master. The composition tab is the final output. So if you put effects there, they will affect absolutely everything that's being played at that specific point in time. Let's again drag my Y-spin 3D onto the composition palette. And as you see here, all the clips that are stacked here are being affected by that. Now, again, what's this useful for? This is very useful for things like adjustments. Very often, I have a chain of effects that I stick on my composition tab, which relate to the brightness and the color correction so that I can tweak my overall output in accordance to what I'm seeing on screen. Different projectors work differently, have different contrasts. You can also tailor things to the specific venue. If there's a lot of lighting, there's not enough lighting, etc. So this is a really good place to put any final adjustments that you want to have on your overall output. Other good use cases for putting effects on your composition would be, for example, if you're going to do a whole set in grayscale, you could put a saturation effect and then you can place all the content on your document without having to worry about adjusting them all individually, and the whole project will be delivered in black and white, for example. Or if you want to tailor a whole set to a specific color scheme, you could put that color scheme on that final output. Last but not least, you can put effects directly on their own clip slot. That means one of these empty slots that don't actually have any content on it. If we go to a Y-spin 3D, place it over there, and then I trigger it, you see that it's basically affecting everything that is below. You've got some settings to define what that clip will be affecting. Go to your clip palette over here. You will see that the input has got a little drop-down menu which lets you select one layer or layers below. Now, what is this good for? This is very good for what I call performance effects, the kind of effects that you're gonna be performing with. Let's say that we duplicate the same clip that we've got here. So now we've got two copies. And now if you do Command Shift T to get a thumbnail in there so it's a bit more descriptive. Might also help to rename this so you know what it's doing. I'm just gonna put a number one there. And I'm gonna put a number two to know what they are. You can put more descriptive names, and also the thumbnail might be helpful as well. Just gonna do another thumb there. So now what we can do here is, for example, tweak that effect so it looks slightly different to what we've got on the other one. So now I can use my clip grid over here to trigger effects. You can do this in other ways. You could place effects on a layer and have a stack of them and then just MIDI map your bypass buttons. But it gets a bit more intricate and more difficult to remember what you're doing. Besides, you won't be actually seeing exactly what is happening. I find this to be way more performative, and it also gives an instant visual clue as to what is happening. So it's very easy to just trigger whatever you need instantly. So those are all the different places where you can place effects. Bear in mind that what I've been describing here are only some guidelines. There are really no rules as to how you place your effects and where you put them. But it's a good starting point to have a general idea of how that's going to affect your workflow in the long term, so that you don't have to undo and redo a lot of work. The permutations of how you use these things together are almost infinite. So you might come up with your own ways of using effects that are tailor-made to the way you work. Please like and subscribe if you find the content useful, and I hope to see you here next time.